Yes, I'm the foodie here.
Everything's better fried.
Yes.
A gut bomb and a sack of the greasiest fries in Christendom. It's just,
because I think there's nothing wrong with making dessert your dinner or your lunch.
Nothing wrong.
Like hot tea, this has changed my world.
I'm like you, Thai hot. I want to see the face of God. I want those endorphins.
Vegetables, that's what food eats.
Okay, I'll go ahead and say,
is it good?
They have cocktails.
Good to know.
They do have very
good
cocktails.
I'll try that.
Check Please KC is proudly sponsored by Missouri's own 360 Vodka, greening the planet, and Kansas City Cocktails, one glass at a time.
Oh.
Yeah. That's the way it works. Hello, I'm Doug Frost, and welcome to Check Please Kansas City, the show where regular folks from all over Kansas City dine and then dish on their favorite restaurants. This is how the show works. Every week, we have three guests. Each recommends his or her favorite spot, while the other two go and check them out to see what they think. This week, Blood Bank manager Chris Troy says it won't hurt even a little bit when you eat the fresh fare at his Westside pick. Direct care worker Andel McGuire says her Lee Summit pick evokes a lot of home-style nostalgia. And now, freelance writer Lauren Van Til doesn't believe in participles dangling nor leftovers hanging at Thai Place in Overland Park, Kansas.
This is very authentic traditional Thai. Thai food actually is a variety of flavors. You're talking about sweet, sour, and spicy, the noodle rice family. We have curry family, stir fry family, and we try to make sure everything, the spice and all the ingredients consistent. And we try to use the most fresh meat and vegetables. And people love Thai foods. We have 20-year customers. Even they go to Texas and California. Every time they come to Kansas City, they want to come here to try the Thai food. And we try to make it very classic and very romantic and also relaxing. So I think everybody should come here to try the Thai food and then taste the difference. If you don't like any food, we want to make sure you're happy, you want to cook anything which you like. You'll be most satisfied with our food, our taste, and our service.
Lauren, how would you describe Thai Place to your readers?
I would describe it as a homey but delicious. I feel like they put together the dishes well. I feel like everything is fancy enough, but not too fancy for your family. And I love to go there with a large group.
So are you a pad thai person, or what
no,
do you like to have?
I actually normally have green curry chicken or green curry seafood. I like spicy. I like my food to give me an adrenaline rush. So when I go...
Let the endorphins run free.
Yes.
Let them run free.
And we enjoy the appetizers, the crab rangoon. Their take on crab rangoon is phenomenal. The wonton wrapper is a lot lighter.
It's not the big chunk of dough, which you usually get with something cream cheese inside.
Right, and it's got a little cream cheese, but it's got a little bit of peanut taste to it, so it's sweet on the inside.
Cool.
And their spring rolls are really good too. So they're a lot lighter than you would find in traditional Chinese fare.
So the green curry chicken, that's
green curry chicken is coconut based, and then it's got chicken and peppers and eggplant.
Cool. Andel, how about you? What would you have at Thai Place?
I had the pad thai. That's always safe if you're a little scared, a new restaurant. Very yummy, huge portions, which is always good in my book because I'm a foodie, love to eat. I also went with my husband, and he got the Bangkok curry. Yeah, make sure you say no spice if you don't like spice, or very mild. Because I got mild, I was dripping sweat. It was good. I really enjoyed it. The crab rangoons are awesome, and I love crab rangoons. They did have that peanutty taste. I loved it. I liked it. It was good. It was a good restaurant. I thought it was yummy. And we went during lunch, very busy. So make sure you go make a lot of time to go.
How about you, Chris? What'd you have?
I had the mother-in-law beef. This is one of my, I live in Overland Park, and it's almost walking distance. So this was my Thai staple until I found hot basil. But your pick reinstated my faith in this restaurant, because my wife and I, we went and we're saying, we're trying new things. But I did the mother-in-law beef, which was this cleaved beef and this just delicious brown sauce with white rice. My wife got a soup, like galanga. It's kind of a cream.
Sure, yep.
Yeah. They were both fantastic. Now I'm like you, Thai hot. I want to see the face of God. I want those endorphins. Because you're that with like a Thai iced tea, then you get that coconut milk.
And it cools it off. The milk will literally fill up the spicy receptors, and it cools it off, and then you can go back for more.
It's fantastic. But you know, we have a 2-year-old, and so she picks off our plate, so we have to tone down the heat. But they were so attentive to her. We get the fried rice for her. She gobbles it up. She's eating my mother-in-law beef. She's having a little bit of the soup. It's fantastic. So I'm glad you picked it because now, I mean, we're going back.
Did anybody do any of the desserts?
We did the fried banana with coconut ice cream. And especially, like, if you're trying to get rid of over that Thai hot, you get that. And it was delicious. Of course, my daughter ate it up. Banana ice cream, yeah. So she ate about as much
what
as I
could go wrong, exactly. And you, Lauren?
We did. We had about 7 or 8 of us there that night at a great big circular table, and we'd all split each other's food. And nobody took anything home, so we were all stuffed, just stuffed. And one person got some mango sticky rice, and it was delicious. It was amazing. Passed it around, you know, but we could all only handle a bite.
They were so attentive, especially to my daughter, because 2-year-olds, they are fidgety, they are impatient, and she was constantly interacting with her, so Lila had a great time because the server was just so proactive.
The help has always been amazing, the wait staff have always been on top of it, and my son has pretty much grown up in restaurants, like Thai Place, especially in Thai Place, and he was, you know, they've always catered to him and very, very friendly to the kids and as well as the, you know, the adults, so.
And is that what drives you back there? I mean, is that what makes that connection, is really watching the way they've treated your son?
It helps.
Indeed. Well, what'd you think about the bang for the buck?
Definitely. Mm-hmm. It bang for the buck. Huge portions. So, I mean, I could go there and split with somebody. Perfect.
And what do you think about bang for the buck?
I think it's a great bang for the buck. I normally, if I'm going with just, you know, my family or just by myself, I always have food left over. And Thai food reheats beautifully the next day. So I always have food left over, but this time, you know, we really had a feast. So.
Indeed. Chris, what do you think about the
value? Perfect. I would have had leftovers, but I'm a glutton. So
yeah, I keep saying, I think I'll box this up. Right. I'm not quite done.
No, and that's, you know, if the service is a bit slow, okay, I can just finish the mother-in-law beef. So I view it as a challenge both on spice and volume. But yeah, I should have had leftovers. But yeah, you can't. I don't think you can get a much better deal than that.
Indeed. Well, Lauren, it was your place. Sum it up for us.
Thai Place is just a great option, I think, for anyone that's wanting to maybe experience something different. If you like vegetables, you like fresh foods, I think Thai Place is a great place to go for, you know, maybe a different twist on a Chinese dish that you like, or just, you know, melding of spices that you maybe picked up in other places or have never had before. And then I think it's a great place for families. So
wonderful. Andel?
Yes, excellent. I can't say enough about it. It's fun, fun decor. I walked in, you know, wanted to get a little Thai outfit, but cute. yummy. I loved it how they catered to the kids. A lot of people, busy. Just excellent choice. Glad we went.
And Chris?
Love the decor, love the service, love the food. How can you beat that?
Okay, well, you can decide for yourself at Thai Place, which is at 9359 West 87th Street in Overland Park, Kansas. Their phone number is 913-649-5420. They're open daily for lunch and dinner. Reservations are accepted. And the average dinner tab per person without drinks is $14. Direct care worker Andel McGuire says the yummy food and the homey feel keep her coming back to Henry's Tea Room in Lee Summit, Missouri.
In 2005, this building came available, and we moved in, and within a week or two, I thought, oh my gosh, we've got to have a tea room somewhere in this building. So we started with one room, and it's grown from there. I wanted it to be a place that you could go that was different than any other place in Kansas City. You could have all your drinks, and you could have your entree and the salad and soup, and then your choice of several desserts. And you didn't have to think about the price, because there was just one price.
All of our food is fresh made. For entree choices, we always have a quiche. And we make our own chicken salad. We poach our chicken from scratch and use pecans and green apples in it. And we also have sandwiches. And we make our own dinner rolls. Our desserts are our favorite, and so we usually have a 6 or 7 selections to choose from. It's a full day experience because you can not only have lunch here, you can go and browse to your heart's content. So if you have a whole afternoon to spend, you can just do it all right here.
Andel, tell us why you love Henry's Tea Room.
Oh, what's not
what's
to
the
love?
Connection? Yeah.
I just love this place. It's in a old church, an old church, and the top floor where the church is the antiques, and it's just fabulous. And then the bottom is the tea room. Mm-hmm. And it's quaint, it's cozy, you get to know them. I just love it. And the food's great, they're very personable, and it's just a yummy place.
So what's yummy? What do you like
okay,
to have?
Okay, I like lots of food there. But I like the chicken salad, which is always nice because they use like pecans and grapes, and it's just the right amount of creaminess. Or sometimes I'll get the other meal and then a side of chicken salad.
The chicken salad is important to
yeah,
you.
Yeah, chicken
I'm
salad is like a
I'm sensing there's
staple.
A connection, yeah.
Yeah. And then, okay, when you walk in, they have these shortbread cookies. The shortbread cookies are really...
I miss those. I am totally angry at myself for missing them.
Yeah, I love them. They know when they see me coming, they better bring out another plate because me and my kids are on those shortbread cookies. They have a really good salad. It has like a blue cheese, a little vinaigrette. That's yummy. And they always have a quiche. Quiche is always good. A dessert. The desserts are phenomenal.
So shortbread cookies are a pre-dessert.
Yeah.
I understand.
Yeah, I
really
I know.
Do
Gosh.
Understand.
And everything's homemade there. So it's just like, you know, when they run out, they run out. So go and order a lot.
Indeed. Chris, did they run out or how were you?
I have to agree, the food was excellent, especially the desserts. My wife got Henry's tea cake, which was the white cake with the coconut cream cheese frosting and a raspberry filling. It was fantastic. I think I got Henry's chocolate cake. It was just standard chocolate cake, but very, very good. Mm-hmm. I was a little apprehensive because of the antique setting about bringing my daughter. And it was we were a little bummed that they didn't have booster seats or high chairs, but we learned ahead of time and we brought one. They were fine with us kind of hooking ours up to the chair, so no problems there. I had the Italian panini, and they said it had 8 cheeses. It, to me, just seemed more like a fancy grilled cheese. I was hoping for a little maybe more herbs into it. I think because it was a panini, I couldn't get all 8 cheeses. Their flavors.
You're separating them, trying
yeah.
3,
trying
4. You know, wait a minute.
I'm in quality, so I'm trying to. No. But it was delicious. The salad was fantastic. And my wife got the spinach and bacon quiche, and that was delicious. My only knock was I wanted more.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm a glutton, and I could have taken about 3 of those slices with my sandwich. And they served ours with a tomato basil soup. It was fantastic. Again, I just wanted a big bowl of it, you know, to dip my sandwich in, but great food.
Cool. And what'd you think, Lauren?
I also had the Italian panini, and I felt the same. It was I felt like it was a little unimaginative for what I was expecting, but I wish I'd gotten the quiche now. I was on the fence. Or the chicken salad. I just couldn't decide.
And I'm going to say the chicken salad.
Right. I think the chicken salad was pretty good. The tea, we had an amazing tea. I used to say that I didn't like hot tea. This has changed my world on hot tea. Their hot tea was amazing,
was
and
it
I believe
the passion?
It was a berry of some sort.
Oh, okay.
A berry tea, like a blackberry tea.
So does the decor make you feel, you know, like you've got to keep your hands, you know, in your lap, or does the decor make you feel comfortable?
I thought so because I didn't know that that's your dessert spoon or fork up there. And you know, that's a knock on myself, not on them, but it was interesting, and I thought that was a unique experience because you should remember your manners there, or at least they might teach you
yeah.
a little etiquette there.
That's another thing. I have 2 boys. So we go there monthly because I want my sons to have good manners. So my son calls it the ladies' place. We're going to the ladies' place. I'm like, yes.
Nice.
He loves the food.
It is. I mean, you live, I assume, in the area.
I live in Independence.
Oh, okay. So it's a bit of a drive for you.
Yeah.
It's worth the drive, obviously.
It's worth the drive. I mean, I love it.
It's a long drive for some people. Would you recommend it for the drive?
I would. It's not too tough of a drive for me, but I would recommend it, especially for what you're talking about. I mean, the manners and the... The upscale dining that you don't necessarily get to have during the day with your child or
exactly.
with, you know, just yourself if you feel like being fancy.
And yeah. Chris?
I agree. I say make an event out of it because I didn't realize how cute downtown Lee's Summit is.
I know.
So I say go there, then go out shopping. They've got the little train station there. I mean, it was really neat. So, yeah, recommend the drive and just That's make a day cool. of it.
Lauren, bang for the buck. What'd you think about that?
I was expecting it to be a little pricier than it was, but it was really not bad. $15... was, you know, you got your entire course, and it was good.
Andel, what do you think about
bang for the buck? Yes, bang for the buck, and I can sure put down those shortbread cookies. So, yes, bang for the buck.
You are getting your value out of it one way or the other. And Chris?
I think it's bang based on quality. I would have liked to feel a little more full. I was hungry when I left. That's a knock on me because I'm a big fatty. So, I'm a glutton.
You got more shortbread cookies?
I know, and I guess I didn't realize.
Next time.
I didn't realize that I could maybe do the quiche with the side of chicken salad. So now I know.
Well, Andel, it's your place. Why don't you sum it up for us?
Great place. Take the kids to learn manners. Just a yummy, quaint place to go learn about antiques, and great place to take mom and dad.
And Lauren?
I would say go with your mom or your aunt or your sister or someone that enjoys that antique and the upscale atmosphere.
And Chris?
I agree with all the above. Make sure they have events such as fall and Christmas high tea. So I say those are great ones. If that's going to be your first time checking it out, go then. I think you'd get a full experience.
Wonderful. Well, try it for yourself at Henry's Tea Room, 401 Southeast Douglas in Lee Summit, Missouri. Their phone number is 816-524-0057. They're open for lunch daily from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. They're closed on Sunday. Reservations are accepted. And the average dinner tab per person without drinks is $15. Now, I don't want to be the guy that tells anybody what to drink, okay? You should drink what you like and eat what you like, but when it comes to dessert, I must admit, chocolate's great, but it overwhelms a lot of wines. I like to use a fortified wine. By fortified wine, I mean like ports and sherries. They've actually dumped spirit in there to make the wine bigger and richer and more powerful to stand up to the denseness, the richness, the oiliness of chocolate. You know, like an ice wine or a late harvest wine. I love those. I'll have them with dried concentrated fruits, nuts, or maybe just by themselves. That's my dessert. Blood bank manager Chris Troy says, please donate blood. And afterwards, treat yourself to the fresh foodie delights at the Westside Local on the West Side.
The Westside Local came to be because we were searching for a watering hole that we hadn't really seen here in Kansas City. Something with really good drinks, a really good beer list, and excellent food to supplement that. Kind of a really eclectic meeting place for all sorts of people in Kansas City. The ambiance here at the Westside Local, we've got great brick walls. The building's somewhere around the 100-year-old mark, and the neighborhood is part of the ambiance.
Well, right now, the quinoa dish is really one of our stars, because it's such a good, healthy dish. And you know, we also have our great mac and cheese, which goes in the absolute opposite direction of it, but it's still a winner. We do focus on local dining as much as possible, as we use stuff from our garden, and I use product from local farmers around the state, Kansas and Missouri. So we're about food and drink and just having a really great time. And when you pair those two together, and you're bound to have a great time.
Okay, Chris, this won't hurt a bit. No, please, tell us about Westside Local.
Westside Local is a great place because I think you get that hip urban feel based on where it's located. Since I moved to Kansas City, I'm from Indianapolis originally, I've noticed that there's a growing local eating culture here, local, organic, and that's coming up. And I like that Westside Local supports that mission. Most of their food is made in-house. I think it's a great place where you're gonna get your standard food, you know, your sandwiches, your burgers, Reuben, and you're gonna get prepared in such a way that you've never had before. I mean, you're gonna get to taste that local flavor.
So what do you like to have there? Are you a deviled eggs guy?
Oh, yeah.
I always have to start with deviled eggs.
Yeah, we start with the deviled eggs. In the past, I've done the Summit Burger, which we brought friends from out of town to this restaurant, and the comment was, this is the measuring stick by which I will now measure all burgers.
Nice.
So, but I actually had the Reuben. What I noticed is their corned beef is a little thicker cut than you might get. And that might be a change for some folks, but I like that. I mean, that means I'm getting corned beef that was probably prepared in-house, that they're cutting it right off. And then we got the mac and cheese for my daughter, Lila. That is fantastic. Yeah. You can get it as a side, which we got for her, or you can get it as a platter. And I don't know if I'll be able to ever go back to, say, Kraft again. I mean, this was ridiculous.
Please, what'd you have? Tell us.
Well, you know me, the foodie. So, okay, I got the chicken salad.
Okay.
Surprise.
What? What? The chickens? What?
I had to compare it. I just love the fact that it was all local. It was just so cool, and that they grow it in the backyard. I was just like, oh, this is so cool. I loved it. I had chicken salad. And then my husband had the Reuben, and we just went on about the Reuben, because you're right about the cut and how big it was. It was just, we had never had a Reuben with so much meat. It was just like, wow, you know? And we had appetizers. Yeah, I kind of went a little hog wild on the appetizers.
Like, so what'd you have?
Okay, we had deviled eggs, And then we had beets grown in the back. I thought that was pretty cool. And then we had prosciutto. That was yummy. Yeah, we had a lot of food there.
So Lauren, tell us about your food.
I got the grilled cheese. There was plenty of cheese in this thing.
Ah, I see.
This was a lot of cheese. But I was there with several people and got to try just about everything. And we had deviled eggs. We had the pint of fries for an appetizer too, because they had homemade ketchup and mayo. Oh, amazing. The salad that came with my grilled cheese was amazing. And I've tried to recreate that salad ever since I went. So yeah, we really enjoyed it.
And how about dessert?
Dessert. I've not really met too many desserts that I don't like. So so banana cake was amazing. There was an apple, it was sort of like an apple turnover, and I can't recall the name, but that was really, really good. It was like mom's apple pie if mom was a chef.
Different mom than I had.
Right.
But that's okay. We're good. It's all good. Chris, did you have dessert?
The brown sugar cheesecake with the blueberry compote. That was fantastic. It was served in like a soup bowl, which is unusual, but it's still got the graham cracker crust on the bottom. It's almost like a creme brulee that hasn't been caramelized on top, but I mean,
I think you're okay with this.
Yeah.
I'm feeling it.
It was fantastic. And the service, once again, I wouldn't have expected it from them because it is a little younger crowd that's going in there. But they brought, before we even had to ask, they had the crayons and the coloring paper for my daughter. They were just fantastic, attentive to her, talking to her while they were taking her orders. So, I mean.
Yeah, indeed. Service, what'd you think about service?
And then we got there. We actually had a reservation for two, and then seven ended up showing up. So they were amazing.
That's a little bit of a change.
Yeah, so, I mean, they did have to seat us on the patio, which it was still warm enough, and it was still nice enough to be able to sit on the patio. We had a waiter that was just right there all the time, you know, filling our glasses, and, I mean, he was really juggling it that night, so did a great job.
And Ando?
Well, our experience was a little different. We got there right at opening at 11. They were on it, but their fryer had broke. Oh. So they had to order a new fryer. And I was kind of bummed because I wanted to try the burger and the fries. But so, I mean, we tried everything else, like I told you. But this was the funniest part of the day. They were playing George Michael, like all for the whole meal. And I'm like, I asked the waitress, I'm like, George Michael fan here? She goes, oh no, the DJ sets the tone for the day. So I got the best of George Michael. That was kind of fun, you know.
Was that the ambiance that you were looking for in
Westside Local? Yeah, like, you know, I was singing along. My husband was like, oh my gosh, you know, it's fun.
Okay, an ambiance to you too.
Yeah, I noticed, and they have the local art. I just love that mission. It's not just the food. It's not just the vendors. We're going to give people a venue to display their artistic creativity and a chance for, you know, someone like me to buy it. Now, I didn't, but, you know, someone else might.
What do you think, Chris? How would you wrap? How would you sum up the restaurant for us?
I would say you are going to pay a little more because that's the price you pay when you're kind of going local. It's not mass produced, but I think you're going to taste that quality. The portion size is great, and it's going to be that food you're familiar with, but just a little bit different. There's something that's going to catch you and say, yeah, this is good.
Well, I didn't ask about that. Bang for a buck. What do you think, though?
It's a little steep than I want to pay, but again, it's the local thing. The local thing's so cool and great for the economy. Just wonderful. Yeah, it's bang for the buck. Local.
Yeah. And awesome. Lauren, what did you think of the pricing?
I would agree. It's a good deal if you're looking for something a little different. There are a couple dishes that are maybe a little higher than, you know, you would want to pay, but normally. But the food, the taste is amazing and worth it, I think, so.
Yeah. Well, you can decide for yourself at the Westside Local, 1663 Summit Street, Kansas City, Missouri. The phone number is 816-997-9089. They're open Tuesday through Saturday for lunch and dinner with brunch and dinner on Sunday. They're closed on Mondays. Reservations are accepted, and the average tab per person without drinks is $25.
Check Please KC is proudly sponsored by Missouri's own 360 Vodka, greening the planet, and Kansas City Cocktails, one glass at a time.
So on this week's show, we featured Thai Place in Overland Park. Chris said he loved the decor, the service, and the food. Andel said, make sure you go with time to spare. Lauren said she shared the food family style and left stuffed. And we featured Henry's Tea Room in Lee's Summit. Chris said, check out the wonderful high tea experience. And Dale said, the food is as yummy as the atmosphere. And Lauren said, go with someone who'll enjoy the antique environment. Finally, we featured Westside Local in the Westside. Chris said, experience locally grown food with a tasteful difference. Andel said she dug the food and she dug the atmosphere even more. Lauren said, the food tastes amazing and it's worth the price. We've had a wonderful time this week. I want to thank my guests, Chris Troy, Andel McGuire, and Lauren Van Til. Please join us next time for three new guests recommending three of their favorite restaurants right here on Check Please Kansas City. I'm Doug Frost, and I will see you then. And cheers. Thanks, guys. Great
Thank
job.
Thank you.
We got to keep talking. Yeah. Goes on for a while. Yeah. They roll credits. Yeah. So, exactly. George Michael. What the hell? Yeah, I've had some funny experiences. I really like the place. Every now and then, there's some moments where you're just like,
That's a peculiar thing.
20 songs, I'm like, oh my.
That's where he must have been like an anthology.
Yeah, he's got a 4-disc.